Perhaps you spoke the kindest words that any friend could say. Perhaps you were not there at all, just thought of us that day. Whatever you did to console our hearts, we thank you, whatever the part. We thank you, we love you, we bless you. Thank you.
Amen. Amen.
So it's my job to weave Ernie's stories as our next four people come up. So the next Ernie story, once again, it involved me. So Marie likes to garden, and as I'm doing my Ernie story, I need my four remarks people to be getting up. That's the idea. So Marie likes to garden, and I don't. Now, I like the way it looks. I like Martha Stewart and Beth Smith's ideals, but I don't garden. I don't like worms. I don't like dirt. Marie likes worms and dirt. And so while I'm talking, I need Gloria, Kathy, Donna, and Heaven. And some of y'all forgot y'all names. And so I went by the house, and Ernie said, she in the backyard. Won't you go help her? I said, who? He said, you still scared of dirt? Uh-huh. You still scared of worms? Uh-huh. I said, won't you go help her? Somebody got to be in the house with the air conditioner. I said, well, let me join you. So we got Sister Gloria first, followed by Sister Kathy, Sister Donna, and baby girl Heaven will bring up the rear. Good morning.
Good morning.
Hi, Marie. So, my job is to talk about the early years. But first I have to give honor to God. With the name of God, most gracious, ever merciful. All praise be to God. To cherish and sustain him. Most gracious, most merciful. Master of the day of judgment. In thee do we worship, and thy name we seek. Show us all the straight way. The way of those who went before us and not those who went astray. Amen.
Amen.
So, I met Marie, or I met Ernie, because we met Ernie all together. Yeah. Marie and I worked for this small group home, Edison Park Home. And is there anybody else here from Edison Park Home? And, so Marie, being the fashion maven that she is, she was always strutting around, being real skinny, and you know, and she was, you know, just wonderful. And you know, we're working with these group of boys and these group of girls, and you know, and we're just out of college. It's a long time ago. And here comes all of a sudden. This big old strapping guy. He was hired, and he and Marie very quietly started a romance. Very quietly. And all of a sudden, it was like, are they a couple? Are they a couple? And Ernie being who Ernie, the man that we know, right? Ernie was always quick-witted. Always had the right comment, the right, okay, always. And so, you know, we always enjoyed his humor, his very dry humor. Okay. Very dry. And his intellect. Very smart, and always, in all the years that I've known her, And you know, and there were some times when we lost contact, right? But Ernie was not one to really raise his voice. He always kept his composure. He always kept his dignity. Okay? And he loved him some way. He loved him some way. So as we started working this job and getting to know each other more, again, I knew Marie first. And as we all, and just watching that their romance blossom was just very interesting. Because Ernie's not, you know, he wasn't a swag dog, right? You know, he wasn't, you know, all, you know, that wasn't his way. He was just very modest, very, very calm, very dedicated, and